Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of death. Amen. Gentle woman, quiet like morning star, so strong and bright. Gentle mother, peaceful dove, teach us wisdom, teach us love. You were chosen by the Father. You were chosen for the Son. You were chosen from all women, and for women, shining one, gentle woman, quiet light, morning star, so strong and bright. Gentle mother, peaceful dove, teach us wisdom, teach us love. Blessed are you among women, blessed in turn are women too. Blessed they with peaceful spirits, blessed they with gentle hearts. Gentle woman, quiet light, morning star, so strong and bright. Gentle mother, peaceful dove, teach us wisdom, teach us love. Teach us wisdom, teach us love. Holy God, we praise thy name. Lord of all, we bow before thee. All on earth thy scepter claim. All in heaven above adore thee, infinite thy vast domain, everlasting is thy reign, infinite thy vast domain, everlasting is thy reign. Hark the loud celestial hymn, angel choirs above are raising, cherubim and seraphim in unceasing chorus raising, fill the heavens with sweet accord. Holy, holy, holy Lord, fill the heavens with sweet accord. Holy, holy, holy Lord.
Turn your ear, O Lord, and answer me. Save the servant who trusts in you, my God. Have mercy on me, O Lord, for I cry to you all the day long. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who caused the minds of the faithful to unite in a single purpose, grant your people to love what you command and to desire what you promise, that amid the uncertainties of this world, our hearts may be fixed on that place where true gladness is found. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord to Shebna, master of the palace, I will thrust you from your office and pull you down from your station. On that day I will summon my servant, Eliakim, son of Hilkiah. I will clothe him with your robe and gird him with your sash and give over to him your authority. He shall be the father to the inhabitants of Jerusalem and to the house of Judah. I will place the key of the house of David on Eliakim's shoulder. When he opens, no one shall shut. When he shuts, no one shall open. I will fix him like a peg in a sure spot to be a place of honor for his family. The word of the Lord. Lord, your love is eternal. Do not forsake the work of your hands. Lord, your love is eternal. Do not forsake the work of your hands. I will give thanks to you, O Lord, with all my heart, for you have heard the words of my mouth. In the presence of the angels, I will sing your praise. I will worship at your holy temple. Lord, your love is eternal. Do not forsake the words of your hands. I will give thanks to your name because of your kindness and your truth. When I called, you answered me. You built up my strength within me. Lord, your love is eternal. Do not forsake the work of your hands. The Lord is exalted, yet the lowly he sees. And the proud he knows from afar. Your kindness, O Lord, endures forever. Forsake not the work of your hands. Lord, your love is eternal. Do not forsake the work of your hands. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Oh, the depth of the riches and wisdom and knowledge of God. How inscrutable are his judgments, how unsearchable his ways. For who has known the mind of the Lord, or who has been his counselor, or who has given to the Lord anything that he may be repaid? From him and through him, and for him all things are his. To him be glory forever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Prevail against it. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus went into the region of Caesarea Philippi, and he asked his disciples, "Who do people say that the Son of Man is?" They replied, "Some say John the Baptist, others Elijah, still others Jeremiah or one of the prophets." He said to them, "But who do you say that I am?" Simon Peter said in reply, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." Jesus said to him in reply, "Blessed are you, Simon, son of Jonah, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my heavenly Father. And so I say to you, you are Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of the netherworld shall not prevail against it. I will give you the keys to the kingdom of heaven. Whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven." Then he strictly ordered his disciples to tell no one that he was the Christ. The Gospel of the Lord. A couple of announcements. God willing, it hasn't happened yet, but God willing, Steve Landsteiner will be ordained a deacon tomorrow at 2 p.m. in Winona. The ordination mass will be live streamed if you would like to watch. Information on how to watch that, the ordination of the 11 deacons for our diocese, is in this weekend's bulletin. Next weekend will be the Catholic Home Missions Black and Native American Collection. The funds raised help provide a wide range of services for mission parishes and programs among Black American Indian and Eskimo communities in the United States. Envelopes for this collection are in your packets. Your generosity is appreciated. There are free copies of the booklet Magnificat in the gathering space. This is a monthly book that has all of the daily mass readings, articles, and meditations in it. Feel free to take one on your way out. Our first reading echoes and is similar to one of the readings we had at daily mass this week. The prophet Isaiah is inspired by the Lord to say to Shebna, the master of the palace, "I will thrust you from your office and pull you down from your station. On that day I will summon my servant Eliakim, son of Hilkiah. I will clothe him with your robe and gird him with your sash and give over to him your authority. I will place the key of the house of David on Eliakim's shoulder. When he opens, no one shall shut. And when he shuts, no one shall open." During this past week, we had a similar reading, similar style reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. And I made it my homily that day. Chapter 28. "Thus the word of the Lord came to me, Ezekiel, son of man, say to the prince of Tyre, thus says the Lord God." Imagine being the prince of Tyre, hearing these words from the prophet. "Because you are haughty of heart, you say, a god am I. I occupy a godly throne in the heart of the sea. And yet you are a man, not a god. However, you may think yourself like a god. Oh yes, you are wiser than Daniel. There is no secret that is beyond you." Can you sense the Lord's sarcasm through the prophet Ezekiel? "By your wisdom and your intelligence, you have made riches for yourself." And he continues on and on and on. And then he threatens him, much like the Lord speaks to Shebna, the master of the palace.
Therefore, I will bring against you foreigners, the most barbarous of nations. They shall draw their swords against your beauteous wisdom. It's on pretty thick here. They shall run them through your splendid apparel. They shall thrust you down to the pit, there to die, a bloodied corpse in the heart of the sea. Will you then say, I am a god, when you face your murderers? No, you are a man, not a god. There's also, again from the Old Testament, in the book of Job, of course, I think most of us are familiar with the basic outline of Job's story. The Lord allowed the devil to tempt him to abandon faith, which he has been faithful his whole life long, to doubt the Lord. And after he loses, after Job loses all of his crop and all of his animals and even the members of his family, he still believes. But then his neighbors come and tell him, you must be unfaithful in some way. You've been sinning in some way, because otherwise the Lord blesses those who are faithful. And Job insists that he has been faithful. And one of his neighbors comes yet again, and they come over and over and over to try to convince him. And another neighbor comes and tries to convince him that he has done something wrong. And Job simply attests that he has done no wrong. He doesn't understand what the Lord is doing, but that he has done no wrong. And then in chapter 38 starts a 3-chapter-long speech from the Lord. It's quite something. You might take it up and read it sometime. I'll only read parts of it. Then the Lord addressed Job out of the storm and said, who is this that obscures divine plans with words of ignorance? Gird up your loins now like a man. I will question you, and you tell me the answers. Where were you when I founded the earth? Tell me if you have understanding. Who determined its size, do you know? Who stretched out the measuring line for it? Into what were its pedestals sunk? And who laid the cornerstone? While the morning stars sang in chorus and all the sons of God shouted for joy, and who shut within the doors the sea when it burst forth from the womb? When I made the clouds its garment, and thick darkness its swaddling bands, when I set limits for it and fastened the bar of its doors, and said, thus far shall you come, but no farther, and here shall your proud waves be stilled. Chapter 40, the Lord is continuing his speech to Job. Then the Lord said to Job, will we have arguing with the Almighty by the critic? Let him who would correct God give answer. The Lord is encouraging a little humility on the part of his people, especially in relation to he who is the one who created all things. Humility, fidelity to his teaching, to his ways. This is why the Lord gives to Peter the keys in our gospel today. The church needs a principle of unity. Otherwise, we will just continue to splinter and splinter and splinter as we see throughout the world. There needs to be that one who is the principle of unity. Not that the Pope, the successors of Peter, are able to speak in God's place as if he is God himself. No, he too is in a place of humility in relation to the Lord. In fact, his duty is not to teach his own thoughts, not to merely give his own opinions on the matters of the day. The way he is the principle of unity in the church is with humbly reminding us again and again of the ancient revelation of the Lord, the true word of God, the tradition of the church, and the constant teaching of the church. This is why the Lord places Peter as the rock of the church. It is for this reason that the Lord gives to Peter the keys to the kingdom of heaven. Whatever you bind, Peter, on earth shall be bound in heaven. Whatever you loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. Such an important function, a function of great humility, to teach the church, to remind us of what the Lord revealed, and always to work to keep us in that unity around that true and authentic teaching. Turning to the Lord, we bring to him our needs and our petitions.
Our responses, Lord, hear our prayer. For Pope Francis, successor to St. Peter, that the Holy Spirit will guide him in proclaiming the good news, promoting unity of the church, and inspiring us to greater love and service, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For healing in cities and neighborhoods, that God will guide leaders in addressing issues of racism, discrimination, and injustice in our communities. Turn hearts from violence and open pathways that will lead to reconciliation, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who will be ordained to the permanent deaconate in our diocese this weekend, for God's grace and blessings be generously poured out upon them, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are beginning a new academic year, that students, teachers, catechists may learn together as they grow in wisdom and love, and that God will protect them from harm and disease, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to the pandemic, that God will deliver the human race from the coronavirus, heal those who are ill, and inspire those who are developing treatment and vaccines, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the repose of the souls of all faithful departed, especially Edward Leonard and Joe Burns, whom we remember at Mass this weekend, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Have mercy, O Lord, on the prayers of your church, and turn with compassion to the hearts that bow before you, that those you make sharers in the divine mystery may never be left without your assistance. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and of all his holy church.
O Lord, who gained for yourself a people by adoption, through the one sacrifice offered once for all, bestow graciously on us, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace in your church, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity,
together with Francis our Pope and John our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom and the power, the glory and the
mercy. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. The earth is replete with the fruits of your work, O Lord. You bring forth bread from the earth and wine to cheer the heart.
I am the bread of life. You who come to me shall not hunger, and who believe in me shall not thirst. No one can come to me unless the Father beckons, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last day. The bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world. And if you eat of this bread, you shall live forever. You shall live forever. And I will raise you up. And I will raise you up. And I will raise you up on the last day. Unless you eat of the flesh of the Son of Man and drink of his blood, and drink of his blood, you shall not have life within you. And I will raise you up, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last day. I am the resurrection. I am the life. If you believe in me, even though you die, you shall live forever. And I will raise you up, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last day. Yes, Lord, I believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God,
who has come into the world, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last day. I am the bread of life. You who come to me shall not hunger, and who believe in me shall not thirst. No one can come to me unless the Father beckons, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last day.